Thought that Buford Furrow had other targets in mind sends a chill down your spine, but what could possibly spark such hate? Joining me now to try to put all of this in perspective is radio talk show host Rabbi Yaakov Spivak. Nice to see you, Rabbi.
How are you?
Good, thank you. When you look at what transpired at this Jewish center and you understand, as we are beginning to understand, what prompted it, how do you put that into perspective?
I think it was a public relations gimmick done by a hate group. The way they operate is to first do something shocking that will attract the media. After they've got the media's attention, then they try to make it more plausible. The shooting of children will attract the media immediately. It's a horrible thing. How could someone do it? And then the attempt is made by the gunman to make it more plausible. Well, I was only shooting at the receptionist, a 68-year-old woman. I wasn't shooting at the kids. The kids got in the way. Mm-hmm. And there are people out there who will say, well, it's a good thing he wasn't shooting at kids. He was only shooting at a 68-year-old woman. So it becomes less shocking, less implausible. Then they interview a hate leader in the Midwest, and he says, well, Clinton kills kids in Kosovo. So this is this. Now it becomes more plausible.
In other words, it's a way, a very, very dramatic way for them to get the kind of attention and get their message out that they are putting out on the internet on a daily basis. But let me ask you, Rabbi, what have these people bought into? When it comes to this kind of hate, what do they believe and what have they bought into about Jews or any other people that they
By the year 2030, America will have a non-white majority. There are people who are very frightened about this. The Jew becomes the main target, but the target basically is anyone who is different from what they consider to be the American basic imprint. America is not like that. They're living in the past. America is a conglomerate of many, many people. This was not a crime perpetrated against Jews. It was a crime perpetrated against American children. And we must see it this way, because if we allow hate groups to divide us, that's the beginning of the end of any democracy.
Right. Rabbi, I want you to stick around. We want to talk more about this after the break. But coming up also after the break, keeping your kids safe is the goal, but is learning at home the answer? Discussing hate crimes following the California shooting at the Jewish Community Center. And we are speaking with radio talk show host Rabbi Yaakov Spivak. And we want to continue our discussion on what these people have bought into that makes them hate so much and turn this hate against people. You mentioned just before the break that these people are threatened by what may soon be a non-white majority in the United States. But Jewish people are white. What is it about this anti-Semitic? Is this our legacy of Nazi Germany that's still with us, or is it a completely unique thing that's existed for a long time?
Some would argue that there is a mystique about anti-Semitism, and we really can't determine why that is. As a rabbi, I must tell you that I feel that the Jewish people have a mission in life. They gave the Torah to the world. They gave morality and ethics to the world. And they entered a world that was very material, and they taught about spiritual things. I think that the Jewish community should be more involved in spiritual things than it is. I think it should be less involved in material things. And I think that when we as Jews fulfill our destiny as a holy people and carrying out spiritual versus material, I think some of the problems that we have, and I don't blame us for it, but I say when we fulfill our destiny as a spiritual people, I think that some of these things will be less.
They will go away?
I think they will be less.
Well, tell me what you mean by that, fulfilling your spiritual as opposed to the material.
I believe that the Jewish community has to really concentrate more and more on spiritual, on study, on learning more about its legacy, about who it is and what the people are about. We gave the world the Torah. The Judeo-Christian heritage comes from us. And I think at this time of year, before the high holidays, we have to really take stock and ask ourselves, why do these things happen? We certainly are not to blame. There is certainly hate and terrible things going on out there.
You're talking about just misrepresentation as far as some people are concerned. But where somebody who would act in this way, Rabbi, wouldn't you say this person is just crazy?
There are crazy people out there. There's no question. I don't think that they're going to be less crazy, but I think that less things will occur to us and happen to us as a people if we concentrate on the spirituality and on our spiritual and holy destiny as a people.
Okay, and what about security at different functions? I mean, we've learned that this man accidentally came upon this Jewish community center because other targets that he had were very secure. Is this something that Jewish communities will consider more and more as a result of these acts, or?
Well, they definitely, he definitely told us that he's a coward, and that when people can fight back, he's going to run, and when there are children around, he is going to shoot. So if that's the case, if he's telling us, we need stepped up security. There's no question. We need that. We need more and more the image of the Jewish people being one that you don't walk in on us and try to perpetrate that, because you will have it thrown back in your face.
Okay. Rabbi Spivak, thank you very much for joining us today and discussing this with us.